BBC TV personality Jimmy Savile was so beloved in Britain that 9-year-old Kevin Cook was over the moon when his scout troop was invited onto the Jim'll Fix It show in 1974. He spoke to us on condition we do not show his face.
He was almost godlike. I mean, everybody, he was so famous. It was just the best feeling in the world. I don't think, anything else could have put me on more of a high.
It was such an honor. His parents saved this newspaper clipping about the show. But Kevin Cook says all that changed when Savile lured the 9-year-old into a BBC dressing room with promises of a coveted Jim'll Fix It badge.
That was when he said to me, "Would you still want your badge?" And I said, "Yeah." And he said to me, "You want to earn your badge?" And I said, "Yeah." And then that was when it happened. He put his hand on my knee and then he started touching my leg. He tried to put his hand underneath, up my leg, into my shorts, which he couldn't do. And that's when he undid my zip and my clasp and pulled my shorts down. And then he started fondling me. And at the same time, he then grabbed my hand and made me touch him on top of his trousers. And at this stage, there was a knock on the door. And then somebody walked straight in, looked, saw us in there, and then walked straight back out. And then that was it. It was over. He said to me, "Don't you dare tell anybody about this. Nobody will believe you because I'm King Jimmy."
A threat so powerful that Kevin Cook says he kept it secret for more than 3 decades. He tried to bury the past and rip this publicity photo from that day. You can still see where it's torn.
I just hated the man. I can remember the day that, it was a few months after this happened, that the actual show came on the TV, and I can remember my parents and everybody so excited, to watch it. And I can just remember watching it, cringing. Even after all these years, I still can't watch the man. I blamed myself for 37 years. That's the first thing. You do blame yourself. And then, I'm realising that it's not my fault. And, that was a relief.
Jimmy Savile, once the face of the BBC, adored by fans. But Kevin Cook and other alleged victims say King Jimmy used his popularity and power to prey upon children. And they blame, in part, the BBC.
I feel hatred towards them as well, because somebody must have known something, and obviously it was just covered up.
Jimmy Savile is dead. And Kevin Cook has no hope for justice, but he says he wants to know just how much the BBC knew and when. Most important, if they could have prevented King Jimmy from abusing him and others. Atika Shubert, CNN, London.